Welcome you all to the next session of Real Numbers. So in this session we will go through the second exercise, but before that we will also go through the fundamental theorem of arithmetic and also see how we can find the HCF and LCM for a given set of numbers. The fundamental theorem of arithmetic states that given a number, any composite number can be represented as a multiple of prime numbers, and this representation is unique. And we need not be bothered about the order. The order may vary, but the representation is unique. Now, what does this mean? Given any composite number, let's take 12. Now, a given number can be represented as a multiples of prime numbers. So, I need to represent 12 as multiples of prime numbers. So, how do I do that? I divide 12 by prime number. So, 2 is a prime number. So, I get 6. 2, I get 3. So I can write 12 as 2 square into 3. So this representation is unique, right? But the order may be different. So I can write it as 2 square into 3, or I can write it as 3 into 2 square. So this is what the fundamental theorem of arithmetic states. Now, using this fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we can find the HCF and LCM of a given set of numbers. Now, how do we do that? Now we find the prime factorization of any given number. Say there are two numbers. So let's take the first example and let us explain what HCF and LCM is. So let me take the first problem which is given, where we need to find the HCF and LCM. So let me take problem 2, the first one, where we need to find the HCF and LCM of two numbers 26 and 91. Right? So here I need to represent 26 as a product of prime numbers. So 26, let me divide it by 2, I get 13. So 26 can be written as 2 into 13. Now consider 91. Let me again divide 91. So 91, 7. I get 13, right? So 7 into 13 is 91. So 91 is 7 into 13. Now what is HCF? Now I consider the prime factorization of these two numbers. I find the smallest power of each common prime. So which is a number which is common in these two? It is 13. And I find the smallest power. So here also I have 13 power 1. Here also I have 13 power 1. So therefore, the HCF is 13. So I need to find the prime numbers which are common to both. And then I need to consider the smallest power. So if I had 13 square here, then I would have taken 13 itself, because 13 is common to both. Right? So HCF is 13. Now what is LCM? LCM is found, which is the product of the greatest power of each prime factor in the given numbers. Now how many numbers are there? There are three numbers, 2, 7 and 13. We need to find the greatest power. The greatest power of 2 is 2 power 1, the greatest power of 7 is 7 power 1, and the greatest power of 13 is again 13 power 1. So therefore, the LCM of the two numbers 26 and 91 is 2 into 7 into 13. So now we also need to show that if I multiply these two numbers 26 into 19, that should be equal to HCF into LCM. So definitely when I multiply these two, it is 2 into 7 into 13 into 13. When I multiply HCF and LCM, I get the same thing. So when I multiply the two numbers, that is equal to HCF into LCM. So before we proceed with the second problem, before we go to the next question in problem 2, let us finish all the questions given in problem 1, where we need to express the given number as a product of its prime powers. So first one, 140. So I need to express 140 as a product of its prime powers. So what do I do? Divide 140 by prime numbers. So 2, I get 70. 2, I get 35. So 5, I get 7. So 140 can be expressed as 2 square into 5 power 1 into 7 power 1. The second problem, we have 156. So again, divide 156 by prime numbers. So I have 2 here. So we get 7 and 8. Again, divide by 2. So we get 3, 9. Again, divided by 3, I get 1, 3. So these are all prime numbers. So 156 can be represented as 2 square into 3 power 1 into 13 power 1. So the third problem, I have 3, 8, 2, 5. 3, 8, 2, 5. So let me divide it by 5. Because I have 25 here, I know that this can be divided by 5. So I get 7. And then 3, 32 is again 6. And then 25 is 5. So again, let me divide this by 5. So here I get 1, 5, 3. And then let me divide this by 3. I get 5, 1. So now let me divide this by 3 again. I get 1, 7. So these are all prime numbers. So I can represent 3, 8, 2, 5 as 3 square into 5 square into 17 power 1. So the next one, I have 5, 0, 0, 5. Let me divide this by 5. I get 1, 0, 0, 1. So now let me divide this by 7. We get 1, 4, 3. Now again divide this by 11. I get 13. So I'm dividing the number by prime numbers itself. So this can be represented as 5 into 1, 7 into 1, into 11 into 1, into 13 into 1. And the last one, we have 7, 4, 2, 9. Right? The big number. So we realize that this number can be divided by the prime number 70. So we get 4, 37. Again, I divide it by 19. We get 23. So this number can be represented as 17 into 19 into 23. So here what we done, we have represented all numbers in terms of its prime powers. Okay, so to do that, we have to divide the given number by prime numbers only, and then we get this representation. So now let's continue with the second problem. 5 and LCM of 510 and 92. So I have 92 divided by prime numbers. So I divided by 2, I get 46. Again divided by 2, I get 23. Next, I consider 510. I divide this by 5, I get 102. So again, I divided by 2, I get 51. So divided by 3, I get 1, 7. So 92 can be written as 2 square into 23 power 1. 510 can be written as 2 power 1 into 3 power 1 into 5 power 1 into 17 power 1. So now here we need to find the HCF. So HCF is the product of the smallest power of each common prime factor. So what is the number which is common to both? The number which is common to both is 2. I have 2 in both the places. But here I have 2 power 1 and here I have 2 power 2. So which is smaller? It is 2 power 1. So therefore the HCF of these two numbers, 510 and 92, is 2. Now to find the LCM of these two numbers, you need to find the product of the greatest power of each prime factor. So I have 2 in both the places. Which is the greatest power? It is 2 square. Then I have 3 power 1. It need not be common. So all the prime factors. So I have 3 power 1. Which is the greatest power of 3? It is 3 power 1. Again, 5 power 1 is the greatest. Then again, 17 power 1 into 23 power 1. So when I multiply all of them, I get 23460. And we can observe that HCF into LCM is equal to 92 into 510. So I leave it for you to do that. So the next one, the third one. So we have two numbers, 336 and 54. So we need to find the HCF and LCM. So let me consider 336. I divide it by 3, so I get 112. Again, divided by 2, I get 5, 6, divided by 2, I get 2, 8, divided by 2, I get 1, 4, divided by 2, I get 7. So we get 3, 3, 6 is nothing but 2 power 4 into 3 power 1 into 7 power 1. So consider 54. So let me divide this by 2. I get 2, 7. And then let me divide this by 3. So I get 9. 9 threes are 27. Again, I have 3. I get 3 here. So 54 is 2 power 1 into 3 cubed. So to find HCF of these two numbers, 336 and 54, find the prime numbers which are common to both. I have 2 which is common to both, and I need to write the lowest power. The lowest power is 2 power 1. I have another number which is common, which is 3. What is the lowest power? It is 3 power 1 into 3 power 1. So this is 6. So HCF of these two numbers is 6. Next, to find the LCM of these two numbers, find the greatest power of all the prime factors. 2. What is the greatest power? It is 2 power 4. 3. What is the greatest power here? It is 3 power 3. And then I have 7. What is the greatest power? It is 7 power 1. So we find that this is equal to 3024. So again, you can observe that HCF into LCM is equal to the product of these two numbers. Next, problem 3, we need to find the HCF and LCM by applying prime factorization. So first one, we have 12, 15 and 21. So when I divide 12 by 2, I get 6. Again by 2, I get 3. So 15, when I divide it by 3, I get 5. And then when I divide 21 by 3, I get 7. So we have 12, which is 2 squared into 3, 15, which is 3 power 1 into 5, and 21, which is 3 into 7. So HCF is what we need to calculate. Now find the smallest power of the common prime factor. What is the number which is common to all the three? It is 3. And what is the smallest power of 3? It is 3 power 1. So HCF of these three numbers is 3. Now what about LCM? I need to find the greatest power of each prime factor. I have 2 here. What is the greatest power? It is 2 square. Then I have 3. What is the greatest power of 3? It is 3 power 1. Then I have 5 power 1 into 7 power 1. So we get 3 square into, we have 2 square into 3 power 1 into 5 into 7, which gives me 420. The next problem, I have 17, 23 and 29. Now we observe that these three numbers are all prime numbers. Okay, so the only number which can divide 17, 23 and 29 is 1 and the numbers themselves. So what is a common number which divides all of them? It is 1. So HCF is 1. And what is LCM? The LCM is nothing but the product of these three numbers, which is 17, 23 and 29, because these three numbers are prime numbers. So whenever we have two or more numbers which are prime, okay, and when we want to find the HCF of prime numbers is always equal to 1, and the LCM would be the product of those prime numbers. Next, problem 3, we have 8, 9, 25. So very simple, we have 8, which can be written as 2 cube. We have 9, which can be written as 3 square. And we have 25, which is 5 square. So what is the number which is common? There is no prime number which is common to all the three. So HCF is 1. And what is LCM? The LCM is, I have the greatest power of each prime factor, which is 2 cube into 3 square into 5 square. So I get 1800. So the next question, 4, the HCF of 306657 is 9. So the HCF is 9. So we need to find the LCM. Now we know that the product of two numbers, so 306 into 657 is equal to HCF into LCM, right? So therefore the LCM is 306 into 657 divided by 9 will give us the LCM, right? So the other way is, of course, to get the prime factors of 306 and then 657 and then calculate the LCM as we have done previously. But since the HCF is already given here, we can simplify the process of our solving by just dividing these two numbers by HCF. So therefore we get the value of HCF. Therefore we get the value of LCM as 22338. 5, we have 6 power n, and we need to check if 6 power n can end with 0 for any natural number n. So n can be any value. Now for example, if I have 6 power 1, I get 6. Now if I have 6 square, I get 36, and so on and so forth. Right? So 6 power 0 of course is 1, and so on. So now the question is, n can be any value. Now can 6 power n end with the number 0? Now if 6 power n should end with a 0 here, so if I have a 0 at the end of any given number, then definitely it should be divisible by 5. But here 6 can be written as 2 into 3 whole power n, right? So the factorization of 6 is 2 into 3. So this number 2 into 3 does not contain 5 or is not divisible by 5. So therefore, for any value of n, for any value n, 6 power n is not divisible by 5. 6, we need to check if the given numbers are composite numbers. So I have 7 into 11 into 13 plus 30. Now what is a composite number? Now let us first revisit the definition of a prime number. A prime number is one which is divisible by 1 and itself. Right? So you have two factors of any given prime number. If I consider 5, 5 is divisible by 1 and 5 itself. But a composite number will have more factors. Right? So therefore it will be divisible by 1 and itself and other numbers too. So, composite numbers are those which have factors other than 1 in itself. So here I need to prove that this is a composite number. So let me take 13 common. So here I get 7 into 11 plus 1, which is 13 into 78. Right? So now here we find that this given number is definitely divisible by 13, is divisible by 78. So it is divisible by 1 by the number itself and is also divisible by numbers other than 1 in itself. So therefore this is a composite number. So now let us consider another number, 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5. So if I take 5 common again, I have 7 into 6 into 4, 3 into 2 into 1 plus 1. So definitely this number will be divisible by 5, by 1 and by the number itself. So therefore this also is a composite number. There is a circular field and it is said that Sonia takes 18 minutes to cover the entire circular field, whereas Ravi takes 12 minutes. Now if they start at the same point and at the same time, so let us assume that this is the starting point. So they start at the same place and at the same time. Now after how many minutes will they meet at the starting point? Right, so when will they again meet, both of them, at the starting point is the question. So for that we need to definitely find the LCM. So the LCM of 18, 12. So 18 can be represented as 2 into 3 square. Right, so 9 into 2 is 18, whereas 12 is represented as 2 square into 3. So what is the LCM? The LCM, of course, is, so what is the greatest power of 2? It is 2 square. What is the greatest power of 3? It is 3 square. So this is 4 into 9, which is 36. So after 36 minutes, we find that both Sonia and Ravi will meet the starting point. So in this lecture session, we have gone through the definition of the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, and we have also seen how we can find the HCF and LCM. We have also seen that the product of HCF and LCM is equal to the product of the two numbers considered. Right? So in the next video segment, we will go through the theory required to solve all the problems, and we will also solve all the problems given in the third exercise of this unit. So I hope you have found the lecture session informative. Please do like, share and subscribe, and press the bell icon to get notifications of further uploads. And thanks for watching.